Hello guys and welcome to the grand finale of the spring tournament in Battle for Middle-earth 1 on the patch 2.22. This time on a beautiful map, Forts of Eisen. We will be playing random against random and we get to play the Isengard faction. Just like most of the time. Dude, it's unbelievable. Like 80% of the games I pick random, I will actually end up getting Isengard over and over again. I mean, I cannot complain. I like Isengard faction a lot, but there are three other factions and sometimes I believe that the random is actually rigged, or I am just an evil person who always gets to play the evil factions because the other 20% is actually Mordor, you know? I barely get Gondor or Rohan, especially Rohan is one of the factions I never get. Okay, so let's capture those settlements and Uruk-hai from the Uruk pit.
Uruk-hai will rise from our new Uruk pit.
Ready weapons.
I mean, early on, when you play Isengard, you need to be a bit more defensively. That's very important because especially now, with the opening we did, we have only Uruk pit inside the castle. That means we heavily rely on the two Lammermyrs outside. And keeping them protected is essential.
We've run into some wargs.
We attack soon.
He might rotate from the top side, and with the other Uruk-hai, we need to actually check. Oh, I see one peasant. I'm not gonna use Warchant here. I think we can deal with them even without the Warchant. That's the one thing you need to always understand. Like, don't use your buff if you don't have to. Now when the Hobbit is arriving, maybe we will have to do it, but I mean, I don't know where the second peasant is. Like, he's eventually hiding him somewhere, maybe at the top side. We need to scout. Scouting is very important. Oh, the game is freezing for a second. Okay, we should be fine now, once again. And Meriadoc Brandybrock is actually being extremely annoying, just like his nephew, you know, Peregrin took.
Get going. Move your feet.
I mean, I have no clue where those peasants are, by the way. I have no clue. So I'm gonna just attack his settlement. He's hiding them quite nicely. And we can use Warchant here now on this two at the same time. And then we can use one of them to deal with the Hobbit and the other one to check the area, what is going on. Because I'm certain he's hiding a peasant somewhere on the map. I don't know where, but he's hiding him somewhere. Okay, so we got maybe from the top side. Let's actually check this area. And in the meantime, keep recruiting more and more Uruk-hai. That's very important. Oh, you look, you see, guys, that's the game knowledge, guys. I'm telling you, like, if I wouldn't check this area, those peasants, if they can reach out to my Lammermyr, oh my, please attack, dude. My Uruks, they don't want to listen, boys. Dude, look, what is this Uruk-hai doing now all of a sudden? Do you guys see this? The small freezes, and you know, that's the one thing I wish would not exist in the Battle for Middle-earth games, the lag, you know, like the command lag is the most annoying lag, actually. Basically, when you tell your units to do something and they don't want to do it, that's the most annoying lag in the game.
Ready weapons.
I mean, it's kind of unfortunate because he's killing our Lammermyr workers and we might even lose this mill. Let's repair this with the worker. Our eco is not looking good, guys, and that's why we need to creep. Like, let's talk about the matchup between Isengard and Rohan. Like, when our opponent would be Gondor, we can actually easily contest the map control, but against Rohan as Isengard is quite tough, because Rohan is able to recruit multiple peasants, which are very cheap, and also you can get them from every single farm on the entire map, and with them you can pressure all the time, and they are also one of the greatest counters to the Uruk pikemen, which we need to recruit to deal with the Rohirrim, so you see what I'm trying to say, right? It's a tough matchup. Let's lure the Vargs away. He has the Rohirrim on the field, and we need to creep ASAP. We also need to creep because, first of all, we need to deny him the creeping. Second thing is, we need to get the money. And third thing is, we need to get 2 power points to unlock the industry, which is very important because, as you can see and tell, our eco is not looking good at all. I cannot believe this. The Berserker is driving me crazy. Dude, what are you doing? What are you doing? I mean, I'm gonna lose them, actually. Let's get the money, please. And we need to recruit more pikemen. Dude, this Meriadoc Brandybrock. You guys see what he's doing to me? This guy's annoying as hell. Holy guacamole. Please kill him at least. I hope you will be able to kill him. Okay, let's capture this. I think he's also creeping, which is, you know, okay, because he needs to try to get to the power spike of the 3 power points after the draft to summon the Elven Allies. It's very important for him to deal with the pikemen in long terms. Yeah, peasants can be used in the settlement fight, but when you want to rush the enemy base, peasants won't be very helpful. But elves, they can, you know, keep their distance and shoot from a far distance. And they are dealing a lot of damage to the Isengard pikemen. So we need to be kind of careful. I mean, it is expected, right? We have nothing to defend this area. I want to use War Chant and creep this one as well, actually, at the bottom side. Oh! He's so lucky that he was in the wedge formation. Did you guys see the formation of the Rohirrim? Okay, let's build the third furnace and let's use industry without waiting. When you do this, the industry is also going to affect the building which is under construction. You know what I'm saying? So the second the furnace is built up, it will also be affected by the industry. Okay, I mean... This game is not looking good for us, boys. I'm telling you. This is actually not looking good at us. Oh. Hopefully he won't be trying to steal the money. It would be quite awful if he would. No. He doesn't want, he doesn't want to risk it. Oh, but he's annoying, right? You want to buy the farm and... you know, oh my. Dude, that's what I'm talking about. You see how fast those peasants are killing our pikemen? That's unbelievable. Oh man. We need at some point eventually some Borka Heirs, but we cannot afford that right now as we are talking. I think what we gotta do is we need to recruit Lurds very soon. And the good thing about Lurds is when you recruit them early on against peasants, you can actually use the momentum and level them up all the way to level 5, which is essential for the Isengard army to get the constant damage leadership unlocked. And also Lurds, overall one of the best heroes, as you guys know, has everything that a hero needs. Cripple, you know, carnage, pillage, everything.
Watch it. There's one of those berserkers.
I mean, I don't know what happened at the top side, but I think I just killed a Rohirrim unintentional. I don't know what happened. So we need to micro around now. Hopefully, we will be able to kill those peasants. And, oh, he's trying to kill my berserkers. And I'm trying to kill his peasants, but unfortunately, our pikemen are so badly damaged, I don't think we can do it. Oh man, and the thing is, those berserkers, they're actually quite expensive units, and I think we need to stop doing this. Eventually, we gotta give map control. Look how many peasants he has. That's what I'm talking about. It's annoying. Now we have Lurds cooking. He's gonna join the battlefield very soon, the fighting Uruk-hai himself. And I don't know how close he is for the Elven Alliance. I mean, I have no clue. But I think we crept two lairs, right? One on the right in the middle and one at the bottom right. And I think he crept everything else, so he needs to be really close to the Elven Alliance Summon, which might us make lose the game.
Listen up. No resting. No resting.
I mean, our eco is looking really bad, guys. Really, really, really bad. And we might need to go for the devastation. Normally, I don't like to do that because I want to get to the Freezing Rain and then right after into the Balrog Summon ASAP. But I think we need to make an exception to this rule, and we will desperately need the money from the devastation. Devastation is actually pretty underrated. It will give you a great chunk of money instantly, while industry gives you that over time. So if you need money right now, devastation is very nice. But again, it also needs some trees to be harvested. When you are on a map and there are no trees at all, then devastation is not going to be the greatest call in the universe. But... oh! Can I please kill him, Lurds? Lurds! Oh my goodness, he's gonna get away. The Rohirrim, I don't know what he's doing. He has no upgrades yet. Oh, he has Elven Alliance now. He has also King Theoden on the field. Okay, I think we need to group all the pikemen at the same point and then Warchant them at the same time. And also we need to cripple. Make sure that he has also heavy armor now, right? And Forge Blades. So he's... very tanky. We gotta make sure to kill Theoden first. So this way, the Rohirrim are gonna lose a very important amount of armor and damage leadership. Cripple! Nice. So now we can go inside the jeans, boys, and hopefully our buffed peasant, not peasants, the pikemen are gonna be able to take him down. I mean, the thing is, Theoden is a very squishy hero, especially when he's mounted. Oh my goodness, he literally got one-shotted. I wanted to make sure that Lurds can get the last hit, but hell no, brother. The damage is crazy. Basically, the mounted heroes are taking 150% increased damage from the pikemen versus when they are on foot. And also, even without that, Theoden is one of the squishiest heroes, which kind of makes sense because he's more like a sportive hero in this game. All his design is sportive. Fear resistant, leadership, glorious charge, king's favor. He's basically like a walking statue, you know what I'm saying? Providing you lots of utility But he alone himself isn't very useful as a fighter. I mean, he wanna fight this, but I don't think about that. I don't know about that. I mean, they are level 2 pikemen and he ran into us. I don't think he can win this fight. Now we need to try to get some map control, but it's easier said than done, you know? We also need to buy every upgrade like banner, forge blades, heavy armor, and also fire arrows. Again, Isengard's eco mid to late game is very strong, but early game, it's actually quite weak, and for that reason, we need to stall. Like, basically, we gotta stall the game, right? That's all we can do. We cannot push him really back. Oh my goodness. I told them to retreat, guys. But they don't want to. Because this is no rabble of mindless orcs. These are mindless Uruk pikemen. They do what they want. Okay. Oh, but yeah, he has theory leadership here. Even with the pikemen, I cannot deal with that. The thing is, if you are, you know, using Rohirrim or Gondonites and you have like really highly leveled, you know, units, and or you have full leadership plus upgrades, then you can, you know, fight the pikemen in one-on-one situation. You don't want to trample them. You want to stop before the fight begins, before you trample them, and then fight them in the melee range. This way you can actually make sure. Oh, we got a micro round. I want to. Oh, no. I don't think it's gonna work. It's gonna work out. All right, yeah. He just invested for no reason money for the forge blades and lost the full battalion. And he would also get away from this area. So, okay. I mean, I'm gonna go for devastation, guys. Like, we have to. Let's use Palantir and then devastation right after. Now we have finally the money we need for the fire arrows upgrade. Because with the thing with the armory is you wanna demolish it ASAP, right? You wanna be done with it as soon as you can and then demolish it immediately, because it's a waste of spot in your castle. And you wanna fill it with a furnace to get even more money, because map control, we cannot really get it. Now he has even peasants with heavy armor. We have no chance. We have no money for the war riders either. So for that reason, we need to make sure that our base income, like our castle income, is at least looking good. And it's not good when one of your spots is wasted for the armory. But not anymore. Oh my goodness, what have I done? What have I done? Dude! What have I... And he got the last hit too? And he got the last hit too? And he has almost glorious charge too? Are you kidding me? Well, that's not good, boys. Hey, I'm telling you, to be honest, I cannot even say that I was throwing my lead, because I have never a lead in this game so far, but this guy is actually playing really good. The only mistake he's doing, he's actually not putting enough pressure on the castle. Maybe he's too afraid of many pikemen I have in the castle, but as long as our castle is remaining on the field, there is always hope, as Aragorn would like to see. And giving up is not in my book, guys. Never give up, never surrender. Let's buy banner so they can recover over time. Look, our money. Dude, we are so poor, guys. We are so poor.
Lurch is here. He'll know what to do.
Okay, industry is going to be helpful. And devastation also. We also need to recruit at some point, Saruman. We can fight this eventually. The thing is, we need still 2 levels with lords. 2 levels. That's what we need. We gotta make sure to get the pikemen and porcupine formation just in case you wanna engage on us. I don't know. I mean, I think we don't need to fight here. We can actually kind of beat them inside the castle, and then our towers can start shooting them down. I wanna cripple his Theorin. Please don't move, Theorin. Thank you, Theorin. Appreciate it. Okay, Theorin is gonna die. Like, once again, he's a very squishy hero, and our units are still buff from the war chant. They are dealing 50% more damage. Oh, you don't wanna do this, my friends. Yeah, let's go. King Tyrion is no more. And now he will also feed us a lot of power points. Once again, in the mid to late game, the game is becoming a power point race. And you want to get to the point in which you can summon, when you are playing evil factions, your Balrog to destroy the full castle. And also in the upcoming versions of the patch 2.22, the Balrog is going to be reworked a bit. And we will try to find a solution to not make him too weak, that he's going to be way worse in compared to AOD, but also not you know, make him win the game single-handedly by destroying a full castle of... Less talking, more gaming. I just lost my Uruk pits for no reason.
Keep your weapons close.
Get ready to fight.
Line it up.
It's fine though, it's fine. I guess so. I mean, we can recruit now 2 crossbowmen. In order to get your Uruk pit to level 2, you need to recruit 2 crossbowmen into 1 Uruk AI. That's the fastest to get it to level 2. And that's what we're gonna do in 2022. And our money is still not looking good, but the devastation is almost back up. So the second devastation is gonna be available. We're gonna use it again. And you will see with yourself, you know, with your own eyes, how impactful devastation can be. It's a very underrated ability. And you should be definitely using it way more often. Palantir to see what's going on, and also we can use it on the he has Rohirrim Archer now with the fire rose. Boom, you see 1500 we get instantly. At this point I want to actually start saving up for our wizard, because then we have even more leadership. The thing about the Rohirrim Archer battalions are that he has now the chance to hit and run. He has the mobility, he has like basically elven warriors on horse. But their weakness is fire, so in a straight up combat between our combos against his horse archers, we will be always able to win, especially when Lourdes gets level 5.
Keep your weapons close.
Pick on the pace. What are you?
I want your weapons.
Is that them? Is that the enemy?
You'll do what I say.
Okay, I mean, we should be in a good spot, I guess, right? We should be in a good spot. We are 2 power points away from the freezing rain. I know, it kind of feels bad that we cannot leave the castle, but trust me guys, I would love to, but I can't. Like, the second I leave my castle, he's gonna come in, and then he will destroy my full castle, and I cannot leave this, because I'm not as mobile as he is. He can beat me to our outpost. I know I have no map control, I know I have only one single settlement outside, and by the way, Theodin gets just level 4. Like, he just got Glorious Charge, guys. This is bad. Let me tell you that much. This is bad. I mean, I wish I would be able to leave the castle, but I can't, especially not with Lourdes level 3 and without Saruman, and even with them. It's gonna be kind of tough to leave the castle, because the thing is, I can not leave like 2-3 combos inside the castle and hope for the best, because the second he comes with the Glorious Charge, my combos without leadership inside the castle will die in a second. So I gotta keep them kind of together. And I know it sounds rude and also lame, but I gotta camp it out. We need also Tainted Lands. The reason is because I'm thinking that he will go for a engage with Glorious Charge and Elven Wood. If you don't know what Elven Wood does, it will shut down our leadership bonuses. And that's why, but this is something like a Wombo combo you can always do. The second you use Glorious Charge, before your charge begins, before you charge inside enemy lines, you can use Elven Wood on top of the enemy units, make sure they are losing all their bonuses, and then you trample them and you kill all the units at the same time. And for that reason, we gotta be prepared to cover this with our own Tainted Land.
Keep your weapons close.
I mean, I'm down. He's giving me a lot of time. And eventually, I will be even able to recruit Saruman, which is very good. I can't. I don't know. Like, I don't know, man. I don't know. I'm so scared to go forward, guys. I don't want to wait inside the castle either, but I'm so scared of doing this, you know? It's so risky, man, because he has nothing to lose here. Like, you gotta understand, if there is a fight and you have not much to gain out of it, but your opponent can literally gain so much more if he wins the fight, it's not a good fight to take. Because what we're gonna gain when we fight at the outpost, we won't be winning the game of that. You wanna fight this? Okay, we gotta be ready with the Tainted Land, boys. Yeah, I told you guys. In the second he's using that, we can cover this now. But he still dealt a lot of damage. Lourdes is still not level 5 yet. But we crippled his theory.
No resting. Spears down.
Get ready to fight.
Make sure that Lourdes is not dying. That's very important. Kill King Theorin. Oh, he's feeding so many power points now. He's riding into the pikeman. He used heal on his hero, but I think we can still do it, right? Right? I mean, die, Theodin King. Theodin, oh! My lords! Don't kill my fighting Uruk-hai. And I have great news for you guys, because we will have now Saruman, the White, coming on the field very soon. And the thing is, Lord's level 5 is already an insane power spike for the Isengard army, but his pillage is even greater. So the second he gets level 6 and unlocks the pillage, he will make us rich for killing all these heroes and units. So long story short, the most cost efficient unit in the game. Don't kill my level 2, please. Don't kill him. Don't kill him. He's so young. He's a full battalion, by the way. If I can save him, I can make him recover. Please don't kill him. Don't stop, pikeman!
The new power is rising. Its victory is at hand.
I'm not gonna... Dude, the Saruman actually scared me so hard. I was jumping. What the heck? I forgot that I recruited him. Okay. Yeah. It's... You wanna fight now? You wanna fight this? I don't know about that. Your I can't even talk. Your Tyrion is actually dead now. You know, you cannot fight this. Okay, now we can actually look for our engagement. We are also really close for the Freezing Rain. The problem is, since we picked up the Tainted Land, the Industry, and the Devastation at the same time, that actually will delay our Balrog summon so much. So much. Oh my goodness, he's coming with a huge army. He's sitting his back on the menu. That's the one thing we need to nerf, by the way. That's so funny, because heroes, when you kill them, they have like such a low revive time that actually it's like a strategy. You can lose them on purpose. This way you can recharge your, you know, hero powers even faster. I mean, we just killed Theoden like, what, 1 minute ago, and he's already back on the menu. So we need to increase the revive time of the heroes, so it's a bit more punishment when you lose them in the upcoming version. And you can also download the patch 2.22 with the launcher from the link in the description down below, by the way. Fireball! Boom! I mean, not the best fireball, but it's okay. We gotta... Oh my goodness, my pikeman. We gotta start somewhere to collect power points. And Saruman is actually a great power point collector. So you can keep doing the fireball all the time the second it's available, and then keep generating more and more power points to get to the Balrog special summon.
None shall oppose us.
I mean, as you guys see, he doesn't want to fight, right? He doesn't want to fight army against army, which kind of makes sense, even though he has more army, but quality goes over quantity. We have more leadership than him, and our lords is all about hit level 5. Now with the Freezing Rain, we can actually look for an engagement and eventually take him out. Let's try our best to make it happen, boys. Okay, now we have enough combos. I want to still leave some of them inside the castle just to be more safe. And I would also like to get one pikeman with this army eventually. So, you know, you don't want to do this pikeman-crossbowman combination. There is a reason for that. When you, you know, make this pikeman-crossbowman combination, they are good when the horses are trampling you down, but the pikemen in front are horrible against fire arrows. So they are dying way sooner than the Uruks would die. Uruks are way, way better. That's why it's better, you know, when you have like a mix and then you put like one pikeman. And the good thing about the situation is, oh my goodness, here's a huge horse army, dude. And the good thing about the situation is we have now the pikeman, and we can also use the porcupine formation with them. Oh, this army looks scary, boys. What do you guys think? What's gonna happen? I don't know. Like, we have rain. We have rain. It means all his leadership bonuses are gone now. He's focusing our heroes down like crazy. Cancel. Okay. He's disengaging. Okay. I take it. I think he disengaged a bit too soon, but maybe it's okay because, you know, we have 100% armor now as we are talking. 50 from Warchan and 50 from Saruman. My combo is... Oh. Can I steal them, please?
You would be wise.
Oh, cancel. Okay, nice, we canceled it. We gotta kill those buildings. I see Aragorn too, but again, he has lots of heroes for leadership, but leadership is negated now from the Freezing Rain. I think he's a bit too scared. Looks like this Aragorn has no Anduril. We can catch him actually, guys. Lurtz is faster than Aragorn when Aragorn has no Anduril, because besides giving you additional armor and damage, Anduril also increases the movement speed of your Aragorn. Look how slow he is without Anduril's sword. Boom. You shall not pass. We can kill him now. We have also Lurtz level 5, which means 60% increased damage. permanently as long as Lurtz is alive and around.
Where is the ring?
I want to steal them, but the thing is, I don't know if I can approach this with my Saruman. Saruman is level 6, by the way, that's good. Level 8 in patch 2.22 will also unlock the Will of Saruman, which means we will be able to heal our army and even Saruman himself.
Victory is at hand. Slaughter them all. Clear the way.
I mean, it looks kind of weird, because we have literally picked every power point from the spellbook until now. The only thing we are missing is actually Field of Fires and the Balrog. And we will not pick up the Field of Fires. And he's coming. That's what I'm talking about. You see, I was rotating to the outpost, but he was using his mobility advantage now to move quickly to my base. But luckily we have some defense, not much. And the good thing is, the Freezing Rain is still active. And all these towers are also shooting down constantly, dealing constant damage. Oh, but he has Glorious Charge once again. Okay, Beal, 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 Beal. Fireball and run. Fireball and run. Fireball and run. Run, 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 you fool. Run, you fool. We gotta cover this Elven Woods. Saruman, keep running. Keep running. You can do it. Saruman. Saruman. You fool. Sorry, Saruman, I couldn't see. Oh, there is. I didn't even see this Legolas. What the heck? Okay, we gotta be careful. This guy's focusing our heroes like crazy. Use heal to save his Legolas. We have Palantir on cooldown. Palantir can also be used to make your heroes run faster. This way, a lord, which normally, I mean, a hero that normally has the same movement speed like Legolas, can outrun him, chase him, and then catch him with the cripple. This is industry once again. The thing is, he just killed two of my level 3 furnaces. Don't lose the level 5 pike combo battalion. That's a very valuable unit. You want to keep them alive. And we are 11 power points away. So now the plan is simple, guys. You will hate me for this, but I have no choice. So I gotta camp it out until I have enough power points for the Balrog. And then with the Balrog, we will be moving out with the army. Use the Balrog to kill the enemy bees. Cripple? Cripple? Theodine King. Oh, yes. Oh, my goodness. Cloudbreak. Cloudbreak doesn't stun us because we have highly leveled units, and also Lurtz gives you fear resistance when he's level 5. But also, what Cloudbreak does, besides stunning the enemy units, is also reducing their armor and movement speed. Look how slow we are now. Holy moly. Slow. Run, please, combos, run. Okay, I mean, the good thing is we are always able to save some units, and they will be respawning and recovering over time.
Crossbows! Stay alert! Line it up!
He's trying, but he doesn't want to look for an overcommitment. We want to hit and run all the time. Look our army, though. Look, we have so many units, though. What the heck? You guys see how much of an army we have? That's crazy. Need Saruman back soon, and Freezing Rain is almost available once again. So, I think we need to play around the Freezing Rain. So, we don't want to go for a risky move when we know the Freezing Rain is on cooldown. And Saruman is back in the business. We need a bit more than one level to unlock the Will of Saruman.
Come to me, my creatures.
Listen up. Back to camp. We come.
Keep using speechcraft every single time it's available. Every single time. That's essential. More levels, more DPS, more tankiness. Like, you get such... Oh my, this guy is actually playing out of his mind. He's splitting his army in two pieces. But we cannot do the same. Boom, fireball, okay. We are collecting power points as we are talking, though. Like, let's kill this Legolas first, and then... Oh, my lord has to be careful. Let's not... You know, he doesn't need to shoot. I want to kill this Legolas first, because I want
to
collect power points. And then we gotta take care of this army. The thing is, our furnaces are level 3. They are quite beefy and tanky, and... Oh! It means he cannot one-shot them, you know. But look at this guy, dude. He has like a... Dude, this army is even greater than the army of Rohan in the films. What? Aragorn, he has still no Anduril. I don't know why not. I mean, he just used Cloudbreak. I'm assuming he will also try to save up for the EOD. But Aragorn without Anduril is not very strong. Trust me on that one. So you want to always pick up the Anduril, which is a huge damage, armor, and also movement speed. Bonus for the King of Gondor, who is fighting for Rohan.
Pikes, grab your weapons.
We will
I think we gotta place some ballista inside the castle. That's the only way we can kind of move out from the base. Because, oh, but again, we can maybe, boom, fireball, again, collect power points. We got actually lots of power points. And that's what Saruman is the best for, you know what I'm saying? He's so good in those kind of situations to gather you many, many power points. Okay, we need only 4 power points, guys. Now we gotta make a move. Now is the time for us to shine. We will leave something in the castle. We will be moving with Saruman and Lords in this 4 combos. 5 combos. And we have Orchan, we have Freezing Rain for the worst case scenario. We are as strong as Isengard can potentially get. You cannot get much stronger than that. And we can make the enemy units as weak as we can do with the Freezing Rain. Okay, let's commit now. Let's see. If he doesn't demolish these buildings, we will get so many power points collected. Now let's recruit some. Cannot fight this. There is no way he can win this fight. I mean, doesn't matter how many more units you have. It is about quality. That's why investment into heroes is essential. Oh, he's smart. He's demolishing the buildings. You see this? Because the well statues, they give you so many additional power points. Okay, let's kill this outpost. We have 16 power points collected. Industry. Oh, what is Legolas doing here? Legolas, thank you very much, Legolas. Appreciate it. Appreciate it, Legolas. Hey, man. He's win trading us. Legolas is a paid actor, by the way, guys. Also in the film. Also in the skin. Okay, so what we gotta do now is we... Yeah, dude, listen to me, guys. Listen to me now carefully. Because I have a 400 IQ plan, okay? So we need to buy the outpost with Saruman. Hold on, we need to defend this first.
We have work to do.
I mean, he killed the siege wall, but it's okay. It's okay, it's okay, no problem. We need only one power point, boys. One power point only. He's also trying to gather power points, I think. I don't know how close he is for the EOD, though. I have no clue. Killing furnaces doesn't give you too many power points, but killing those sentry towers does.
We have work to do.
Okay, now we have the Balrog, but what we gotta do now is we need to capture this, and then we're gonna build towers in it, you know, around the outpost, and then we need to, you know, move now with all the army we got to the bottom outpost. That's very important, because he has so much map control. That means even if we can kill his castle with our Balrog, there's a chance that he has enough money to actually, you know, rebuy the castle. So we need to look for the win or lose moment. Okay, we have heal for the worst case scenario. Okay, he's losing a lot of units. I don't know what he's doing. I don't know how close he is. I think he's also playing for the EOD. Oh my goodness, this is gonna be kind of close. He needs to go back to heal now. Okay, go. And now we gotta move to the bottom side. We need to try to destroy the castle and the outpost at pretty much the same time. I think that's the only way we can win, because I'm assuming and I'm pretty certain that he's actually very close for his own army of the dead. Breathfire Balrog. I don't know if he's paying attention or not. Maybe he's not paying attention. Oh, my Saruman! Heal! Saruman, don't die, please! Okay, he's paying attention now. So now, go. Destroy the outpost. We have higher level combos with Lourdes, but we just wasted Warchan for no reason. Dude, can we do it, guys? I think we can do it when he has no EOD. I think we just gotta focus on the buildings. Ignore the Alvin warriors, who cares about them. Just focus on the buildings. We gotta go for a victory. Hey, Balrog, don't sleep. Please. We gotta go for the victory, boys. Just focus on the buildings. Nothing else. Okay. Can we do it? We gotta breath fire. Oh. Can we do it? Breath fire. Just step on the outpost on the citadel. That means he cannot rebuild it. Nice. And we destroy. No, he's rebuilding it. Saruman, do it. Your fireball. Saruman. Yes, boys, we are victorious. His EOD came in the last possible second, but it's not good enough. GG, well played. Oh my goodness. This has to be the best game I've played in the patch 2.2. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. If you did, please don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, and also share it with your friends. And thank you for watching. Take care of yourselves and keep hitting like a truck. Peace out.